I am very aware of my anxieties. I don't like the pity party. I don't like talking about when I like don't feel too well. I don't know, I am a little nervous. Just being kind of open about like what I struggle with and like making it known to other people is a bit nerve-wracking. I remember being really young, I'd say like 8, 9, 10, like around that time. And I remember having shortness of breath and going to my mom and telling her that. In hindsight, now I know that that was obviously anxiety. I think being overworked and like being in the situation that I'm in now is kind of what like set it out of control in a way. I've had times where I feel like I need to be rushed to the hospital because I think that like my heart's failing and I can't breathe and I need like someone to like help me. Sometimes I think I'm dying. Sometimes parts of my body will go numb and it can be really, yeah, intense and scary. I mean, there is going to be those people that say like, oh, okay, what is she have to worry about? What does she have to be anxious about? And I'll never sit here and say that I'm not fortunate. I know I live a very privileged, amazing lifestyle. I'm a very blessed girl. I still have one of these, you know what I mean? And that thing up there sometimes like doesn't always, I don't know, it's not always like happy and it's not always connecting. And I'm still a human being at the end of the day. And no matter what someone has or doesn't have, it doesn't mean that they don't have real life feelings and emotions.
As a psychologist in private practice here in Los Angeles, I work with people with a wide, like sort of, so what you call a generalist.
Right.
So different people bring in different stuff.
Right.
But the one thing that I would say every single individual that I've ever worked with has brought in is anxiety. One of the most important things I think is to destigmatize all mental health issues,
right,
particularly anxiety, right, because a lot of people think they're alone with this.
Like you kind of said, everyone I think suffers from, even if it's just a minimal amount of anxiety, but it is something when someone's like, oh my God, I have anxiety about this, like almost using the term loosely.
Right.
I know what that feels like. And like you're using that term lightly and I'm just like, ah.
You gotta remember is anxiety's on a continuum,
yeah,
right? At the milder end, it's probably what these people are saying, oh, I'm feeling this anxiety, but they're getting through the day.
Right.
But one, it jumps a line and there's a point at which anxiety gets in the way.
Right.
It makes people more uncomfortable at work. It makes people more uncomfortable in their relationships. It makes people more uncomfortable out of the house.
Right.
They'd actually just as soon stay home,
right,
than deal with the big unknown.
Right.
And they're physically uncomfortable. Their heart's racing. They feel like they're crawling out of their own skin. They feel sick a lot. Everything's scary.
Right.
And when we get to that point, we call it clinically significant anxiety.
Okay.
It's got a name. Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Now I know.
Now you know. It sounds like social anxiety is something you had even before the pandemic.
Before I was really overwhelmed, really overworked. I was always around people and I kind of got really overwhelmed with all of that to the point where I was like, I need to like be alone. Now it's more like, okay, we've all been super isolated,
right,
to the point where I'm almost like so used to that, that now that things are slowly opening up, if I go to a dinner or if I see a few more of my friends than I'm used to seeing throughout this last year, that gives me anxiety.
I'm gonna give you an analogy. Have you ever been scuba diving?
No, I've been snoopa diving.
Okay,
it's similar.
All right. So we'll build up on that a little bit, because when you scuba dive, if you come up too fast,
right,
like you come from, you know, 20 feet up,
I know this,
you could actually get really sick.
Yeah.
And that's called the bends.
Yeah.
And psychology is similar. Well, from this pandemic, if we go too quickly from being locked in to throwing ourselves right back out there, especially for people with anxiety, they're gonna kind of get the psychological bends.
Right.
And they're really gonna kind of get rattled. So,
you have to ease yourself into it. Right.
We're all learning our skills again. We lost
it. I know, it's crazy.
Social anxiety has a certain look to it.
Mm-hmm.
And people who are socially anxious classically are afraid that not only are people looking at them, that they're criticizing
them. Judging them.
They're judging them. And that the socially anxious person feels like they're doing judgeable things,
right.
or that they're making other people uncomfortable merely by being there. They're
right.
like, oh, these people are uncomfortable because I'm so awkward.
Yeah.
What happens is over time, because that moment is so hard, even before the person gets into the situation, their heart is racing, they mm-hmm. feel sick. The whole experience of even being with people feels so aversive. It's easier to just say, nah, I'm not
yeah.
gonna. I'm
and
not
this
gonna
is
go.
All strictly like mental, mm-hmm. right? It's just everything mental. That your brain is like.
It's all. Hypnosis.
You're just going down a rabbit hole.
Yep, you're going down a rabbit hole.
Wow. Because it feels so physical.
Feels
is why
so
I ask you that. It's like, so I've like literally gone to doctors
right.
because I'm. That's how bad it gets for mm-hmm. me to where I'm like something's literally wrong.
Correct. Panic attacks are the sort of the brick of every anxiety mm. disorder mm-hmm. or anxiety experience we see. It's all a miscommunication in the brain. Everything gets ramped up. It's taking the signals from here. Change this,
yeah.
you change this.
I'm also a hypochondriac, which I don't know if that has any relation mm-hmm. to, like, or if it's the cousin of anxiety or something, but I'm like a massive hypochondriac. Mm-hmm. So, and that's also something that has been a thing since I was really little.
People who are anxious are always monitoring their bodies. It's almost like a Roomba.
Mm-hmm.
You're always sort of like wandering around and vacuuming, mm-hmm. vacuuming all these thoughts in your body. And so if you even feel like a tiny headache, you're like, oh my God, I have
yes.
a tumor in my brain.
That's me,
you know?
That is me.
Or I have some lung disease, I have to go
yeah.
get checked out. Anxiety is like a magnifying glass
mm-hmm.
and it magnifies only the bad things.
Mm-hmm.
Every little ping, every
oh
little this. And so in essence,
it's
what we're
so
trying to do
true.
Is take that magnifying glass and put it to being a regular lens because especially physical sensations, because anxiety is such a physical disorder.
Yeah.
And so that's one thing I always want to tell people mm-hmm. is that they go together and that as the anxiety starts getting pulled away, those hypochondriacal thoughts
mm-hmm.
also start coming down because they're a nuisance.
Yeah.
And so I'm glad you mentioned that because that's really an important thing
yeah.
for people
well,
to
you're
know.
Literally, sometimes I'm bad at putting my thoughts into words and you're doing
beautiful.
It for me. So these are some written in questions from followers and
yeah.
viewers. The first question, how do you open up to people about social anxiety?
Tell your nearest and dearest, like
mm-hmm.
practice talk, having the conversation with the people you feel safest with. People will say, oh, I did not know that.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you for telling me because I won't push
I
as much.
I can support you
can
and
support
now I'm
you.
Aware, right?
Yes.
Okay, next question. How should I handle anxiety over a loved one who isn't being cautious during COVID?
Mm.
Wow, I feel this.
I've heard this from so many people. If you have a healthy relationship, you can explain your point of view and say, listen, this is concerning me for all these reasons.
Right.
Okay? If the person's still not meeting you halfway, like
mm-hmm.
they really are being difficult, I talk about realistic expectations. You're probably
right.
not going to get them to be mask wearing, sanitizer doing,
right.
hand washing friend. Then all you can do is keep your side of the street clean.
Right.
Anxiety's gotten a really bad brand. So
yeah.
I want to also like say something nice about anxiety. Once upon a time, you know, the anxiety is what made us survive.
Yeah.
The anxious people knew to say, tiger coming,
right.
don't eat those berries,
yeah.
looks like something bad's happening.
Yeah.
Anxiety kept us safe
right.
to a degree. And people who are anxious are higher in this personality trait called neuroticism. People who are higher in neuroticism are also sometimes a little bit more aware of other people's
mm.
stuff too.
I consider it like a beautiful thing in
a
way.
It is a beautiful thing.
And I mm-hmm. like that I am really aware of my body and like my mind. I know it can sometimes get the best of me, but
yeah.
I think that I like that I'm in
mm-hmm.
tune and I like
mm-hmm.
that I like, you know, want to know
mm-hmm.
everything.
Anxiety, when it's sort of right in that sweet spot, is a little bit of a superpower because it actually helps you keep yourself safe,
yeah.
keep others safe, and kind of keep you mentally on point. So there's that perfect sweet spot of anxiety
yeah.
where there's just enough where you're performing at the top
mm-hmm.
of your game and keeping. So we want to get you right
yeah.
at the top.
Yeah. So we are asking all the doctors that I meet for some tips and tricks
mm-hmm.
that maybe the viewers can take into account of their own
mm-hmm.
life.
Mm-hmm.
And apply to their life.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have anything, I would love to hear
mm-hmm.
for myself and for
yeah.
all the viewers.
Mm-hmm. One of the best things a person who's socially anxious can do is prepare.
Mm-hmm.
That getting caught, coming late, rushing, that doesn't feel good. So be on time
mm.
or be a little bit early.
Oh my God, I need to be on time.
Yep,
if I'm not, I freak out.
There you go. So if you can be on time or be a little bit early, even if you're sitting in your
mm-hmm.
car and you're like, perfect, now I'm gonna go
yeah.
in, you're less frenzied
mm-hmm.
and prepare. Learn what you're getting into, like how many people are gonna be there? What's it gonna feel
mm-hmm.
like? Almost mentally rehearse it a little,
mm-hmm.
that helps a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So here's the second thing you can take away. A lot of what can help people who are socially anxious is to get good feedback from their audience. Mm-hmm. So a great way to do it is sort of a three-point plan for how you can use your body. It's uncrossing your, I'm gonna uncross my legs too. Uncross your arms, okay? Make eye contact, mm-hmm. and smile. Cute. When you do that, you disarm everyone. And interestingly, when I first met you, you did that right away.
Yeah.
And you put me at ease.
Yeah.
So I felt comfortable. Whereas if I'd come in and you were just sort of distant or aloof, yeah. or remote,
right.
I would have felt anxious.
Right.
So that's a dance, and that right. mirrored dance becomes really, you know, it becomes really important.
Well, thank you so much.
Thank
I'm
you
so glad
much,
I got
Kendall.
To sit with you, and I learned a lot today, so thank you.
And I appreciate you sharing your story, because mm-hmm. I'm always grateful when people talk about their stories publicly so people can see they're not alone with this,
yeah.
because I think the hardest thing of all is to feel alone. So
totally.
Thank you for doing that.
It does definitely feel like a weight is lifted when I, you know, feel something and I hear someone else saying, oh yeah, I get what you're feeling, or this must be what you're feeling, right? And I'm like, oh my gosh, yes. Like, that's exactly what I'm trying to express. And it's that comforting feeling of like, okay, she's either experienced this herself or she knows people that have experienced it, being a doctor who's seen a lot. So it just makes you feel a little, it just makes you feel understood, and that's a really nice feeling.